If it's the most audacious show on TV you're looking for, you've come to the right place.
Who likes getting messy?
Yeah! Oh.
We're setting some CBBC viewers the ultimate daring mission. To hide a celebrity in their home for two whole days without one of their parents noticing.
And if that isn't tough enough, they'll have to do all of this without being caught out.
Welcome to Hider in the House.
Right, we're about to do the ultimate practical joke, which is on a CBBC viewer's parent. Now, we've specially selected some sneaky kids from Bristol to take this mission on. They're good. The ultimate mission? To hide a celebrity in a house for two whole days.
Now, the brilliant thing is we can watch all the action from in here in our super Scooby van. With a flick of one little high-tech switch, we can watch all the challenges that we set, and hopefully if they complete them to our very high standards, they will get themselves a shed load of prizes.
Yeah, the thing is, though, if Dad finds out, the game is up. What are you doing, man? Take it down now.
Have you seen this?
Without further ado, it's time to meet the rugby mad Nicholas family.
James, I'm 13. I like rugby and football. Liverpool! My brother thinks I'm a bit of a chap.
Yeah! Hi, I'm Austin. I'm 12 years old and I've had about a million girlfriends.
Yeah! Hey, don't pick on the little guy. You know I'm small. Anyway, best things come in little packages. Hi, I'm Jason. I'm 10 years old. I love rugby.
Little he may be, but quiet he isn't. So before we go any further, we should point out that Jason isn't one of the family, but he is best buddies with Austin and James.
And now for the parents. There's Naughty Sam, who's in on the trick as well.
Dad's a real practical joker, so to get one over on him is going to be great.
And Dad Steve, who is, how should we put it, a victim.
I'm the main man of the house. Quite strict, I think, probably from my military background. They're always trying to get one over on me, but they've got to get up a bit early in the morning for that.
So, bit of a joker, are you, Steve? Well, the joke's on you.
And all this time, Dad thinks we're filming a really rubbish TV show called Our House.
Hello, welcome to Our House. Come on in.
And what is more embarrassing for us is he thinks we're the presenters on it. But that's just our cover story. He knows we're there, but he has no idea what the real reason is. Just look at some of the rubbish we're getting him to say.
Bath are at home. This is a bath rack, not a pool table. It's a rugby pitch.
James.
Austin.
Jason.
So it's up to the kids, James, Austin and Jason, to play a trick on Dad. But can they hide their celebrity for two whole days? And though Dad is used to having really noisy kids around the house, will he notice anything strange?
I know when anything's going on, if they're misbehaving or whatever they've done.
So it's early on a bright Bristol morning, and it's time to introduce our kids to their celebrity hider. To help us distract Dad while we smuggle the hider into the house, Mum is keeping him busy in the dining room with a good old cup of nice char. So that no one will recognise us and to look as normal as possible, we've come up with the ingenious plan of walking down the street as characters from Harry Potter.
Why did I have to go underneath?
Be quiet, keep still. And you're right, though. You didn't really need that beard.
OK, so not actual characters, but there's a new movie coming out and we thought we might be in with a chance of getting a role. Just look at this acting masterclass. Joel, be careful. Mum and Dad are just in the kitchen. Quick, let's get upstairs.
Hey! How are we, boys?
Hi.
Good, yeah?
Yeah.
James, what are we going to do?
We're going to hide the celebrity in our house for 2 days.
Is the right answer.
Austin, if you do that, what do you win?
Prizes!
What do you win? What do you win?
Prizes!
Prizes!
Right at the minute, Dad is downstairs with Mum in the kitchen, so we really should keep our voices down a little bit. Are you ready to meet your hider, Jason?
Yeah!
Come on, let's bring him in then. Hider, come on in!
Here he is.
What's he doing?
What are they doing out there?
No idea.
Mum, don't look at the camera with that cheeky smirk. You'll give it away.
Yes, they're going crazy for England rugby sensation Matt Stevens. After coming out as runner-up on The X Factor to that woman who used to go out with Phil Mitchell in EastEnders, he's in no mood to be a loser again.
I think my biggest weakness is my size. You know, I'm a big guy with perfectly toned muscles, and it's going to be difficult for me to fit into those smaller spaces.
But does he have any special techniques to make the job slightly easier?
Well, my specialist hiding move is the crouching badger. It's a really difficult move, and there are only about four people in the world who can pull it off. But I'm hoping today that I'm going to be the fifth.
The crouching badger. He's talking the talk, but can he walk the walk?
I've heard Dad's a really sharp character, and he's a big rugby fan, so it's not going to be easy to get things past him. But I'm hoping that the kids and I can put in a performance today.
So Matt is hopeful, but does Mum think they can pull it off? Are there any weak links?
Our chances of success are about 50-50. Steve's pretty sharp. He tends to sense when things are going on. James is very good, as I say, but Austin could well let the side down.
We don't think he will. Will you, Austin?
Austin.
On second thoughts.
Hold your horses. It's time for challenge one.
Dad has settled down to watch some rugby highlights in the living room at the front of the house.
James, you need to do something very, very important. You need to go to the living room and distract Dad. Go for it, mate. Good luck.
Come on, James.
Good luck.
All right.
Let's hope he's up to the job.
This is challenge number one. Now, you might have watched Matt on X Factor, where he came the runner-up, with a combined singing with his love of eggs. Because I reckon that eggs look like mini rugby balls. So, therefore, we've called it X Factor.
X Factor. A brilliantly clever title, if ever I heard one. That little tyke Jason, in the upstairs bedroom, will throw eggs down to Mum, who must catch them and then fling them to Matt.
He then has to kick them over the fence to Austin, who has a net in which to catch the eggs. They need to have 10 eggs in that net in 3 minutes. If they do, they win these balls, boomerangs, and inflatable chair-type things.
And to make kicking that little bit harder, we've put Matt in ridiculously high trousers. Yesterday, Matt Stevens is Simon Cowell.
Go! Come on! Come on, out the window, down to Mum, that's it. Come on, catch! Across to Matt, across, over the fence, to kick it! You missed!
Okay, so there is a little twist. Some of the eggs are hard-boiled, and the others are a little less boiled.
Speed it up on there! Speed it up!
Come on!
Don't forget, James is making small talk with Dad to keep him out of the garden and away from the noise.
Why anyway? Why are you all so subtly interested in my work?
Dad's starting to get suspicious, and the pressure is mounting up on James to keep him in the room.
Come on, speed up!
Meanwhile, after several instants of egg on people's faces, Austin finally catches his first one, but time is running out.
You bored?
Yeah.
You're going to play rugby in the garden?
I'm bored.
I thought you said you were bored.
Yeah.
Good work, James. Don't let Dad outside or the game is up before any prizes are in the bank.
Catch! Ready? How are you doing there, Austin? You got what?
Two!
Oh, that's not good enough. Keep going,
Oi! Watch the camera, Stevens! They still have 8 more eggs to get and only 1 minute 30 to go.
There's one coming over,
It's catch! Oh. Too far!
Get it!
Oh, God!
There again!
Go on! I concentrate!
Mo, that's a catch!
Here we go, get ready, there we go.
Yes!
Yes! 1 minute!
Let's go!
1 minute, standing by, come on!
What are they doing in that back garden?
Nothing.
Probably having a water fight or something.
Well, they're making enough row out there.
So?
Yeah, well, you know what the neighbours are like. They'll start creating and complaining.
So they do the same sort of...
Yeah, well, I'm going to go and...
No, stay here and talk.
Hold on in there, James. Not long left now.
10 seconds! Run! Come on, James!
There's no one there!
James, there's one there! 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1!
Well done up there, by the way. You were brilliant, as always. Shall we see, then, if you've got 10 eggs to win the prizes?
Ready to count them?
You ready?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10! Hey, nice one. Well done, lads. But Daddy's getting restless. James turns the TV up to block some of the noise out, but the boys still have to tidy up the mess they've made outside. And they've got a hide mat. And you've got to do it now!
Remember, Dad is in the next room and could come out at any moment.
Quick, boys, quick!
Yes! They've put an England rugby star in the toilet.
Did you just see that?
Yeah, the kids have locked him in, but from the outside.
Austin, Mum said we couldn't trust you. If it's locked from the outside, Dad can get in, but Matt can't get out.
So Matt has his first hiding place, the luxury of the downstairs toilet. Let's hope Joel hasn't just been in there and that Dad doesn't need to use it.
I'm just going to go to the toilet and we'll go and play rugby at the moment. Sorry.
Unbelievable. How close was that?
As Dad retreats to the upstairs loo, we get his mate Ian, who he usually has breakfast with, to call and take him out for us.
Hello.
Hello, Steve is here. Right, mate?
Hello, yeah.
Yeah, I'm just going to have a bit of breakfast. Do you fancy coming down?
Yeah, let's see why not.
All right then, mate. About 5 minutes.
Yeah, OK then. Bye. Sam, just popping out for breakfast.
With Dad out of the picture, the boys retrieve Matt from the toilet.
Right then, boys, you know your dad's mate Ian? At the moment, he's bribed him into a fry-up, which means he's going to be away for about 15 minutes. That's good for the next challenge. And if he does come back unexpectedly, Mum's keeping cover by the door, so it's all good. So for your next challenge, if you complete it successfully, you win these amazing prizes.
It's a set of radio-controlled planes, which do really cool plane-type things.
Richard!
You like it? Now, big lad over here has been recovering from injury, you know, bless him. So he's fully fit now, but his problem is if we return him in a really bad condition to his teammates, they're not going to be very happy at all.
No.
So the good thing we've got to do is we've got to wrap him up in cotton wool. We've got to protect him, because there's lots of intensive hiding coming up in a minute. So let's play Cottoning On.
So the kids have to wrap Matt in all the cotton wool.
But that's ridiculous, he looked like a sheep.
Exactly. I'm too scared to say it to his face, though.
So they have to turn him into a sheep, clean up, hide him, and all that in just 4 minutes. Go! Protect him, go! Protect him. Come on! Do you like that?
Stop
moving!
Stay there, Matt. You've got a Jason attached to your leg down there.
Talk to each other, communicate. What are you doing? What about this? You've got the big ones here. You've got the big ones.
Stay
there! Bit of emergency. What are you doing down there, Jace?
Wrapping it up.
Okay, will you get some cotton wool going off?
Oh, nice one. Get a move on, come on. Yeah. Even though your dad's having a fry up, he could come back at any minute. I know Mum's there.
He does eat that fry up quite quickly.
Get a move on.
Our man on the inside, Ian, is doing a great job of keeping Dad busy down the local cafe, but there's only so much he can do without Dad getting suspicious.
Right, come on, action.
Right, yeah, let's
come
get
on.
Moving. Come on, let's go,
come
let's
on.
Go,
let's go. Come on,
urgency now.
Step up, come on, move, move, move.
Finish mucking around, let's do this. Come on,
let's do it, come on. Will you
yeah,
do the
other one? Around. put the slippers on.
Whoa, whoa.
What are you doing?
No, you're supposed to put them on, not smacking on the feet with it.
Broken toes.
Nice. Right there.
We'll do it again sometime. Yeah. All right.
Meanwhile, Dad has filled his belly and he's on his way back.
Yeah, see you later. Tell her.
Luckily, Ian knows what's going on and gets on the old dog and bone to Mum to warn her.
What's a dog and bone?
It's a phone, you Wally.
Hello? Oh, right. Right, see you then. Bye.
If Dad realises they're hiding a celebrity in the house, it will be game over. And they've only won one prize so far.
Then don't worry.
Dad's back in 1 minute. Get cleared up now.
1 minute, yeah, 1 minute.
But they can't hide him yet. He's not ready.
Does he look like a sheep?
Yeah, he looks ludicrous.
First task accomplished.
Dad, clean up, come on.
Come on,
quick,
clean
get
up.
It in the bag, get it in the bag. That's it, Jace. Go on, lad, go on. Here we go. Up there, come on, come on.
Come on, get him, get him.
Dad is getting closer and closer as time runs out.
I like to listen to military music when I drive. When I say military, mainly British war movies themes.
The boys look for a good place to hide Matt. If Dad realises there's something amiss at this early stage, the game is up and loads of potential prizes are lost.
Ridiculous.
In our house, we don't have many rules. Rudeness and tidiness are about the only rules that we have.
Tidiness? Did you get that, boys?
Quick.
Look, clean up the mess. He's only round the corner.
Quick!
Dad is perilously close, and boy, is cotton wool hard to get out of the carpet.
Do you think they've ever used a vacuum cleaner before? They're never going to do it in time.
Come on. Roll it, roll it, roll it. Come on, guys, you're running out of time. Come on.
Hello.
Just in the nick of time. They've done it, and more prizes are in the bag for the boys.
Dad's back in the house, and there's a stray piece of cotton wool in the kitchen. Will Dad suspect something is up?
Hi.
Are you all right?
Yeah, you.
Here he comes in. It's the moment of truth. Dad has walked into the kitchen. Oh, oh!
He's got straight for it!
Yeah.
Those kids.
The pressure's stepping up. He went straight to the cotton wool, but has no idea of the mess the kitchen was just in. Well played to Mum for keeping a great poker face.
I'm telling you, that's just too close. Leaving Matt cramped up in the cupboard, the boys take a well-earned break before it's time for challenge three.
A message.
All right, boys, doing really well at the moment. Loving your work. Yeah, you're doing brilliantly, but no chance to wait. Get to the van. It's time for your next challenge. Come on, move now!
Come on, boys, let's go.
Come in, boys. Here they are. Come and sit down, full of smiles. The little bundlers of joy. I'll tell you what, I was really impressed with your last challenge. Three tasks for you here that you need to get your dad to do without him realising that it's a game. First one is for you, Austin. You know that New Zealand rugby team? They do that thing, I think it's called the hooker, where they go,
hey, hooker! Yeah, yeah, yeah,
you mean the hooker?
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Anyway, you've got to get dad to do that.
Right. Now, Jace, I reckon this is going to be really, really difficult for you, right? You've got to get Dad to say Matt Stevens' name. Have a think about that, okay? It's going to be hard.
We haven't forgotten about you, James. You ready for yours?
Yeah.
I think yours is possibly the best. You've got to get Dad to sniff your mum's knee.
Hey?
Yeah. What? Dad's got to sniff your mum's knee. So, do you reckon you can do this?
Yeah.
Yeah? Yeah?
Right, now, Matt is still hiding in the house, yeah? Which is good. Now, the thing is, and you've got to know this about rugby players, you can't leave them for more than 20 minutes without any food, otherwise they get really angry. And believe me, you do not want to see Matt Stevens angry.
We have to release him and we have to feed him within 15 minutes, OK?
Yeah.
You're not really worried?
What are you doing sat there?
Prizes!
Go, 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 go!
The boys could become brain boxes with these family board games.
Yeah. So challenge three, and the tension is high. Everyone gathers in the living room. Can the boys get Dad to do all three tasks? To recap, Dad needs to do the hacker, say Matt Stevens' name, and sniff Mum's knee. Sit back and enjoy the show.
What have you been doing today?
Nothing much. Just finishing off what we did yesterday.
I've been sitting here all afternoon, and I went to the club for a bit.
And we had a little bit of food for it, as you can
apparently
see.
Why, what have you been doing?
Where was that?
In the garden.
So why are we having a food fight?
So what's that?
Well,
I just loved it.
Made some
Sam.
That's egg buns from where you dropped the packet of eggs on me earlier. Yes, and it does smell.
That.
Stinks.
Was it?
Smell it.
Egg.
You dropped the carton of eggs in the kitchen on me.
Wait a sec, he plays for England. He's a massive star, look at him now.
Quick, smell it. No, that's nasty.
If it's eggs, it's chicken, it's going to be foul, isn't it?
Go on, smell it.
Oh, sniff my knee, how aggressive is Mum? Go on, sniff it.
That.
Go on.
It's not that.
I reckon it's nasty, I can smell rotten eggs.
Oh, that's the first one done. Get in!
Don't forget, all this time, Matt is crammed in the cupboard upstairs. And they only have 7 minutes left. Part two is to get Dad to do the New Zealand rugby chant, the hacker.
Dad, you know New Zealand rugby team? Yeah? You know they do the hacker thing?
Yeah.
Can you show me how to do it? I
forgot. How to do it. You just make funny faces and stamp your feet.
Clever boy, well done.
Ready? Imagine. Pot of shampoo.
Yeah.
Timotei, pour it in. Wash it. Timothy!
So that's task two complete. Their final one is to get Dad to say the name of the man who squashed upstairs in their cupboard. It's Matt Stevens.
No one here, right?
Yeah.
Knows the name of the England. He plays for Bath, I think, right? Knows the name of the England number three.
Martin Peters.
Or he can play number one.
Grucol. Danny Grucol.
He plays for Bath. He was on X Factor, I remember that now.
Tell you what, that little Jace, he's on the ball.
Matt Stevens.
Yeah!
Oh, Jace, well done, little fella. Great tactics.
Great, brilliant.
Yes, thank you.
Oh, this is boring.
Cuff up the cash.
No,
come
James,
on.
If you made a bet.
Come on, cuff up the cash. Come on, cuff it up.
Mum, what have we told you about that cheeky smirk? I thought it was Austin we had to worry about.
Oh, a nightmare. Hard day.
Hard day, Dad. We're barely halfway through, and there's still loads of prizes to be won. You've done the challenge, boys, but you've forgotten the golden rule. Always look after the hider.
Oh, hang on. So the boys completed their task in time?
Yeah.
What about Matt?
Where's...
The 15 minutes are up, and like an angry, hungry bear, Matt is out of the wardrobe.
Matt, get back in. Matt's in there, get back in. Matt, get back in. That's not fair, get back in.
Good. Fair play, Jason's good. So with disaster narrowly avoided, Dad heads out for his next round of the show that no one would want to ever watch. It's Our House.
Now here we are at the Red Lion, my local. We're now going to go into the pub and I'm going to try to explain the laws of the offside rule in rugby. There's only one ball, but they are oval, like an egg. These are round. So these are people, not balls. Right, the ball's in there.
Well, the balls are people.
The balls are people.
Oh, whilst Dad bores our cameraman to death, it's time to head back to the house for challenge four.
Offside rule.
So let's get straight into the challenge.
Bath bun fun. The boys are tied together in a rugby shirt with James and Austin blindfolded. Jason has to use his considerably big mouth to guide the boys around the ingredients, dipping the buns into the jam, the icing, and the raisins to make bath buns. Then feed them to Matt. Matt must eat 4 in 3 minutes, and if they do all of that, they can get sporty with a range of outdoor games, which is indeed a marvellous prize.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1!
Go, go, go! Go.
Meanwhile, Dad is still trying to explain rugby's offside rule.
Bristol's scrum, because Bath knocked on.
Forward a bit, James!
They can't hear you! They can't hear you! Shout louder!
Down! Down there! Down! Left a bit! The coin! Down!
They can't hear you! They can't hear you!
Left! Down! Back! Back a bit there!
Oh, that's it! That's a good one! That's a good one! Go back to the table! Go back to the table! Right, you want the raisins? You want the raisins back on? The raisins back on.
Left a bit.
No, where's that hand going? Put that hand behind it. Right, come on.
Austin. Yeah?
Oh, no.
Right, OK, right. Go on and get in. Come on. Come on, get it in there. Right, go on, get another one. Quick, come on.
Back at the pub, Bristol. We get an update.
Bristol's put the ball in. Scrum half's come round the back to collect the ball from the scrum. The Bath scrum half has come round, but he's gone offside. Referee puts his hand up for a penalty, but play goes on.
Right, come on, you've got to really shout at him, really shout at him.
Right, down, left.
That's it. Come on, go.
Left.
Not even listening to it, look.
Forward a bit,
they can't hear you. Come on, get the raisins in.
Just dip it down.
Come on, dip it in.
Raisins!
Oh, you've broken your head! Oh, I love when he dropped the raisins on the floor!
Oh,
you ruined it!
When I said move left, where did you go?
I thought you did well, guys. Yeah, I thought you did well.
I thought you did well. Unfortunately, you didn't win those prizes. There's one way here that Matt could really help you out and win these prizes, if Matt does the forfeit.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm going to do it now when you rub icing all over my face.
No, you're
accomplices. Steve Rugby Club.
It's entirely up to you, Matt.
Come on, do it.
Who's England's best player?
Matt!
Yay! Who's Bath's best player?
Matt!
OK, I'll do it.
Yes, it's time for the forfeit. Are you sure? You know we can only have it once a show. I'm sure it's time to suck the sock. But where is that sock from this week?
Yes, this week's sock is an antique turn-of-the-century piece. The year 1900, a vintage year, a French classic, I believe. No one in Paris during this time would dare be seen without one. And plus, it really does smell.
Suck the sock.
Suck the sock.
Here is the sock. Here is the smoothie. It's time to suck the sock. Suck the sock.
To win the prizes for the boys, Matt must suck all of the smoothie through our sock of choice. Whilst Matt sucks a nasty, smelly old sock, our cameraman stalls Dad for as long as he can by filming him getting in and out of his car. Again. And again. And again. And again.
I'm not doing that again. Oh, out of breath.
You know what I'm
going to
ask?
What?
One more time.
Who needs rugby to keep you fit when you're being filmed for our house?
Come on, suck it. Hang on, one sec.
Hang on, it's done. Are we all done? It's done.
Hang on, suck this. Come on. Come on, a bit more sucking going there.
Suck the sock. He's done it.
Fantastic.
No.
The good thing is that Matt has won you the prizes.
Yeah!
The bad news is Dad is very close.
Now, it's the last challenge of the day. You've got the prizes, but you've got to get Matt out of the house right now. So what are you waiting for? Get him out of the house! Go on, get him out of the house! Go on, get him out of the house!
Let's leave him to it. Come on, let's get back to the van. For the final challenge, the boys have to get Matt out of the house before Dad comes home.
And it's going to be close, because he's just round the corner.
Oh, no. They are running straight towards him. That's Dad's car!
Where are they?
No!
I can't watch!
It's all right. It's all right. Dad went straight past them. No idea.
Hello.
Well done, boys. You've got Matt back to us in one piece. We've had a great day today, and you've won some amazing prizes so far. And also, for bringing Matt back to us and smuggling him out of the house, you've won this amazing prize.
Enough rugby balls and kit to start your very own team.
Hey, nice, isn't it? Good stuff.
Oh, yes, yes. Now, remember, tonight is a massive, massive test for you boys. You've got to keep it quiet from Dad, OK? He cannot suspect a thing. Nothing. Shh. Are you with me?
Yeah.
I said, are you with me?
Yeah!
Give me five, Jace. Shh. Off you go. Go. Get out of here. Go, move.
Off you go.
It's the end of day one, and what a day it's been for our England rugby international celebrity. He's been dressed as Simon Cowell.
Shoved in a toilet.
Made to look like a sheep.
Shoved in a cupboard.
Had bath buns pushed in his mouth.
Smoothie poured down his throat through a dirty sock.
And by doing all of that, our kids have won loads of prizes.
But it's only the end of day one, and tomorrow he'll have to do it all over again.
It's been a long day.
Yeah, it's been a long day. Absolutely. I can't wait to get to sleep.
Oh, me neither. Oh, I'm cream crackered.
So where are you guys sleeping tonight?
Well,
the arrangement...
Well,
I'll be having my pillow anyway.
Yeah, my pillow as well.
It's a good job you're bigger than me.
Yeah, whatever. have wolves in Bristol?
It's day two, and as the sun comes up over a sleepy Bristol, Dad is up and raring to go for another exhausting round of our house filming.
There are plenty of challenges ahead, but what do the boys think of everything so far?
Today's gonna be so hard. Yesterday was so fun, but quite difficult. So tired.
Yesterday was amazing. I want to win all the prizes like we did yesterday today, but the challenges are getting a lot harder.
You have to be really quiet because Steve's next door. We had a great day yesterday. The boys did really, really well. I'm really concerned because Steve's getting quite suspicious now as to what's going on, so we're going to have to be really careful for the rest of the time.
I better get off and get dressed ready for filming.
JK, are you awake? I can't feel my arm.
Because it's my arm, you fool.
Oh, I can...
Worst night's sleep ever.
I can feel my arm now.
My hands are freezing. I can't feel my feet. You fidget. I'm just having a nightmare. It's day two. We've got shed loads to get through. Can't believe we're just sleeping in a... We have a slight problem.
He's taken Teddy!
No, Matt's gone missing. I think we need to tell the kids. I don't know about Teddy?
As fears for Teddy's safety grows...
Will you leave it about Teddy?
Sorry, to warn the boys about Matt's disappearance. We're off to the house while Dad goes about his morning routine.
So, are you ready for the filming today?
Yeah, I'm like a hole in
the head. Looking forward to it then.
Yeah.
The boys are up and waiting to see what challenges are ahead.
Quick! We've lost Matt, have you seen him?
Home.
Don't be stupid. Dad's in the kitchen with Mom.
We need to get in.
Let's go upstairs.
It'll be all right.
Because Dad is still downstairs right now. Mum is looking after him. She's doing a sterling job. But you are going to need to clear this mess up, OK?
If they win this challenge, they get these robots. But be careful, they may try and take over the world!
Now, what you need to do is put on as many items of clothing as you can. What you can't fit on, put them into this bucket, all right?
What, on us?
Yeah, that's what you've got to do on you, all right?
Then hide Matt, all right?
OK.
Ready? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1,
go!
Now, I'd love to stay and chat, but unfortunately, I'm allergic to oranges.
You're not really allergic to oranges, are you?
No, of course not. But if Dad comes up and finds his bedroom in this state, not only will the game be over, but he'll be furious. Quick, let's hide in the van.
Put that on. I think. It is, yeah.
Stop messing around, boys. Be quick.
Quickly.
The boys still have some way to go before the bedroom is tidy, and Dad must be close to finishing his cup of tea.
Have a cup of tea before you go?
I thought you'd never ask.
Ah, Mum. The classic tea top-up, straight out of the distraction rule book.
Think of all the prizes at the end, boys. Stick this on. Quickly.
Can I spray some of this on myself?
I can't get the smell of that broom out of my nose.
What? Yeah, I think you probably need it. I think I'll spray you all down with a bit of that.
Go on now, I've got no hands.
Oh, okay.
Ready?
Boy, that's my rugger spray! The sweaty smell of man in a can.
Are we doing what?
Socks up. Oh, jeez, yeah. Let's go. Come on, you get the signs off the door.
Take the sign,
Do it! So they've completed the task in time, but they still have to hide Matt.
Look at that, I think Dad might have heard them.
Hear them? Up and down the stairs like a herd of elephants. What's the matter with them?
They're just excited.
Yeah, well, you sort them out.
No, leave it, they're fine.
Well, you sort them out then, it's all the time.
No.
Okay.
Skip!
Boys, stop slamming the door so loud!
Hang on, hiding behind the curtain there. Dad's bound to see him.
That's rubbish.
So with Matt hidden very poorly behind the curtain, Dad leaves for his final round of filming for my favourite TV show, Our House.
Dad's going out the front door, he's bound to see him.
Oh no, he's gone straight into the room that Matt's hidden in. He's looking straight at him. Surely it's all over. I don't believe it. He hasn't noticed him. Matt just dipped out from behind the curtain to avoid being seen through the front window. Quick thinking for a big lad there, Matt. And the coast is clear for the next challenge. Cue that military music, Dad. Pumpity pump, 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 pump.
Yeah, I'll just read that back to you then. It's 6 fries, 4 garlic bread, a Hawaiian, Giuseppe Rossi, a Peter Crouch, an Emmanuel Petit.
Don't forget my omelette.
And a plain omelette for JK. Mamacita, portobello, no, no. Yeah, thanks, Mum. Yeah, cheers, bye.
Finished?
Yeah.
Anyway, using technology that we've stolen...
I think we'll find it's borrowed.
Borrowed from NASA, we can track Dad's every movements from this fantastic laptop here. Honest, Harry, no questions asked. Anyway, I can tell you right now that Dad has left the house, and he's also on his way to work, which means we can get in to our next challenge. Oh, it's a belter. Onwards!
Oh, yeah, Mum, can you make that 7 fries? I'm feeling a bit peckish.
Who likes baked beans?
Yeah.
No?
Who likes getting messy?
Yeah!
The boys must increase Matt's weight by at least 1 kilo. This will be done by James and Jason throwing the beans from a saucepan into Matt's plastic trousers. Austin will stand at the side deflecting any stray beans into the trousers. If they increase his weight by 1 kilo, they win. And the prizes for completing this challenge are these beautiful MP3 players, complete with speakers.
We have a weight for you, which is 123.1 kilos, OK?
Big man.
That needs to go up to 124.1 kilos to win the prizes.
Right, boys, choose your weapons. Get into position.
Into position.
We're going to make a right flipping mess. Great name for a challenge. 2 minutes on the clock. Come on, you got to do this, boys. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Go!
Go! Go! Go! Come on, you've got to get him in there. Come on. Two minutes. Oh, hang on, that's it.
Guys,
that's
keep it going.
Come on, 2 minutes. 15 seconds.
That's the idea, Jace. Right in his face.
Actually, that's not the idea. It's meant to go in the trousers.
All right, sorry.
Come on, stinks, man. Watch me.
Meanwhile, our poor rubbish cameraman is feigning interest as Dad talks through the names of tools with him.
Ah, a little tool kit. You got everything you need.
Yeah. So and I?
Yeah.
Screwdriver? Spanish?
Spanish.
Yeah.
Oh, fascinating, Dad. Back to the beans!
Swap round!
Yeah! Gonna move on, come on! Watch me!
With 10 seconds left, James uses a little more skill and finesse to get the beans into the trousers.
Good lobber!
Here we go. Good jumping!
Remember, he needs to be weighed to see if he's a kilogram's worth of beans in his trousers. He needs to be at least 124.1.
126! Yeah!
But while we celebrate, Dad makes his way back to the house.
All this time, we've been watching Dad's progress on our state-of-the-art tracking device.
Right, hang on, that red dot there is next to that red dot there, which means Dad is definitely on his way home. He's about 2 minutes away, so you've got to clean up and hide. Matt, go on, go! Clean up!
Move!
Come on!
So the boys try and get beans out of the grass and off the patio, and have to hide Matt before Dad gets back.
I want to escape!
Dad is getting closer and closer, and the beans are proving hard to get rid of.
Will you stop messing around? Come on, urgency, we haven't got much time. Get on with it.
Freeze it.
Quick, boys, clean, quick, quick. The final beans have come out. The boys still have to run into the house and quickly change. I hope it's not too late.
Dad is back to take all of the family down to the rugby club. If Matt isn't hidden in time, the game is up.
Get back in the room. Matt, quick, down the side of the bed.
Come on,
quickly.
Come on, James.
Oh, is that mine?
Yep.
I'm on it.
Dad doesn't seem to suspect that anything is up. I think they've got away with it.
Hang on a minute, Sam. I forgot my boots.
Oh, wait a minute. Dad's going back upstairs to get his boots. He's literally a metre away from our celebrity.
Matt has to be completely silent, or it's over. It's just as well he didn't go into the garden. Don't think all of those beans have come out.
OK, off we go, Dad.
For the first time, there is silence in the house. Matt, like the good hider he is, stays hidden. Is he asleep? I think he might be. Come on, it's time for us to wake him up and follow the family down to the rugby club for their cheekiest and most daring challenge yet.
Matt! Gotta go to the rugby club!
Come on!
Come on!
Run,
here
run,
he goes,
run.
Come on, come on! Training come on. Session, training session, go. Come on!
Sweet chariot, coming for
sorry.
You, carry me on. Sweet love, sweet chariot,
coming there's for the...
Dad is a coach at the local Cleve Rugby Club, so we're about to head off for our next challenge.
We've arranged for Dad to give a rugby lesson to a group of children down at the club where the family are regulars, but this will be a rugby lesson with a difference.
Dad is getting ready with the Our House cameraman filming his every boring move.
Right then, boys, you ready for this one? This is definitely. Your biggest challenge today, the best prizes so far. Right, this is going to be absolutely brilliant. In just a second, your dad is going to be taking one of his amazing little courtships out there. He's going to be doing stuff on the field with all his regulars, but what he doesn't know, in his little seminar, he's going to be taking on Matt Stevens. You're going to be involved.
Matt's first task is to join in the session. If he goes unnoticed, his second task will be to join in the scrum with Dad so that he's only inches away.
His third and final task is to run around the field with his rugby top over his head in a football-type celebration. If he does all three and Dad doesn't notice, the kids win this. It's a games console with a selection of sporting games.
The only way you win this challenge is to not get recognised, obviously.
Okay.
And the challenge finishes when you come off and get yourself subbed off. All right, you up for that then? Oh, yeah, and one little added extra for you as well, so you're not so lonely.
Okay.
My little co-host, JK, is going to be involved in that game as well.
And remember, everyone's in on it, apart from Dad. So here we go. Oh, it's tense. Dad's in good spirits and is about to start the lesson. Matt is well hidden by the side of the pitch by our band of stooges.
OK, then, listen in, boys.
Oh, here we go. We're starting with some shuttle runs.
Run to the five. Five to the 10, to the 15. Back, touch your partner.
Well, what's JK up to there? Star jumps? Rubbish.
Press up. Off you go.
Did he say 50 press-ups for the losers? That's a bit harsh. That's Dad's mate, Steve, who's Matt's body double, and he's relishing getting one over on his friend. Can Matt complete task one and join the session without Dad realising? Oh, there goes Matt now, using the other boys to hide him. Very clever. Any moment now, and tack. The swap is made with the aid of a cunning hat. Our celebrity joins in. He's only metres from Dad. He looks straight at him, but he hasn't clicked. Unbelievable. That's part one of the challenge complete, and Matt heads back to shelter behind our extras.
Challenge number one. Is he blind?
However, the next part is even harder. Kelly's massive 18-stone frame joined the scrum without being recognised.
There he goes, hang on.
And we're off. Dad is talking through the scrum, blissfully unaware that an England rugby international is about to join in. He has no idea.
Let's move around this way.
There's little Jason in his hat. He's actually been quiet for once. Oh, must be nervous. Matt's crept up behind Dad. Good hiding technique there, Matt. Classic manoeuvre, copied from the 1984 Russian champion, Ivan in a box along.
That's all I say, you're ready, OK? Right, flankers, you got your positions? Flankers? Yeah, flankers. James Green, number 8.
He's in! He's literally a metre from Dad. And Dad doesn't realise.
Stand up until I...
Jason, you're doing a great job there trying to cover him.
He's definitely in it, and Steve's still not looking at him. He's looking the opposite way.
Hang on.
Right, up you get, ready.
Dad has broken the scrum up, leaving Matt exposed.
Right.
This could be the end.
Listen to me, listen to my commands, OK? Second row's in.
Phew, he's back in, and the scrum has started. Excellent work. That's part two of the challenge completed.
Come on, in first! Come on! Hold it there.
Disaster struck. His hat has been knocked off in the scrum. Get out of there, Matt. Get out!
We've done it!
No, we haven't, you muppet. We've been busted at the final hurdle. It's all over.
Matt Stevens has been in your house for 2 days!
I've been watching you with your missus on the sideline here. You did not notice him at all?
No.
he just joined
me running up and down.
I didn't know.
He's been living in our house for 2 days.
Has he?
Yeah.
It's a very nice house.
Yeah. Kids, did you all know about this?
Yeah.
Did you know all about this?
Were you in on it?
Yeah. Yay! All right. So, where's your boys? There they are.
James.
Here they are.
And Jason. Jason's been involved with it, so I think I've got some explaining to do, so can we get you back to the house and show you something very exciting?
Yeah, go on then.
Ta-da!
Hey!
How are you, Dad? How's it going?
Steve,
everything good?
You all right, mate? All right.
Wicked.
So Matt Stevens has been staying in your house for 2 days.
Yep.
You know nothing about it?
Didn't have a clue.
Do you want to see the evidence?
Go on then.
What's been going on in your house? Here we go, watch this.
Hi Dad, Matt Stevens here. You may have seen me playing for Bath and England, and maybe on the X Factor. You're probably wondering what's been happening in the last couple of days. Well, your wife and kids have been hiding in your house.
Okay, Dad. So you think we've been filming a show called Our House, featuring fascinating insights into your life, such as this.
Important piece of the office equipment is our shredder.
In fact, whilst you've been performing for the camera, your kids, James and Austin, their friend Jason, and your wife, Sam, have been taking part in a top-secret game show called Hider in the House.
Their mission was to hide England rugby hero Matt Stevens in your house for 48 hours without you realising. And believe us, it wasn't an easy task, because, of course, he's a big man. And there have been some very close shaves where you nearly bumped into each other.
Sorry.
Your boys and wife have been taking part in several challenges to win prizes.
Here, Moses!
Considering you're a man with a military background, you haven't spotted that your house has been turned upside down with mess everywhere.
Suck this up!
They completed 7 tasks and won loads of prizes. But they could have won more if you hadn't spotted him.
I've been working hard for 2 days and you've been having fun.
There you go. Round of applause for Dad.
Brilliant.
Yeah.
Brilliant.
Dad, as you know, Matt Stevens is still hiding in your house. If you don't pin him down for a while, he goes on a walkabout, okay? Right. So he's still in your house somewhere. Right. You have 90 seconds to find Matt. If you find him within that 90 seconds, you get the Bath Sound rugby shirt by all the team and you get the bath tickets. 5 tickets to go and see them play.
3, 2, 1, go, 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 go.
Now your time is running out. Time is seriously running out.
It's the moment that everyone loves.
Yeah. What? The bit where the princess gets to kiss the prince?
No, you muppet. It's time for the prizes. Shh.
I knew something was going on, well, I thought I knew, but totally gobsmacked.
There was a few sticky moments where I thought maybe it was all going to fall apart because Steve was a little bit suspicious, but I don't think he ever imagined what we were actually up to. I think he had all sorts of suspicions, but nothing like what we've actually achieved.
My favourite thing was when we were chucking a beanstalk in Matt's trousers.
Can't wait to use all my prizes!
I've been having so much fun these past few days, I've actually lost my voice.
Oh, what a great couple of days. Go on, puss. Oh, do you know what? That little Jason, I tell you what, he reminds me of me when I was young.
You?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Gobby and short.